there, guys. SC Mothership checking in, bringing you game number two of this best of five series with EG Puma spawning in the bottom right as the Blue Terran against JYP spawning as the Red Protoss here in the top left of Shakura's Plateau. Now, in the last game I did a little Brood War style series, so for those of you who were panicking and couldn't handle the change, I put it back to normal here, so you've got all your fancy little gadgets here, you know, right when the what point of the game we're at, you know who's ahead. So if you really did enjoy that sort of style replay, if you like the ability of not knowing just how many workers your opponents or the two players have and what supply they're at, please tell me. I really want to know which is more preferred. I mean, because honestly, I'll end up doing both, you know, kind of switch back and forth. But if it's something that's just really unbearable to watch, it's not a good viewer experience, obviously I'm not going to keep doing it anymore. But both players starting off once again relatively normal here. We are seeing that wall off, so Puma could decide to do something similar to the last game. Although I wouldn't be surprised to see him do some sort of one rack expand, just because it is pretty common here on Shakura's Plateau because of the nicely defendable ramp you've got here at your third or your natural expansion. It makes it very easy for you to defend against any sort of invaders coming up your front ramp. Likewise, JYP could decide to do something similar like we saw in the last game where you went for a one gate expand. So both players have plenty of options at this point. Take a quick look at the income tab. Nothing too drastic happening yet. We are seeing Chrono Boost allowing JYP to get one extra harvester out. Chrono Boost obviously increasing the production of one building by 25%, I believe. Or we'll take a look at 50% faster for 20 seconds. So I feel like a total noob for not knowing that. But hey, everyone noobs up every now and then. We are seeing that first gas go down. So looks like a very similar opening to the last game. We see that second gas go down here pretty soon. I would expect almost the same exact opening here by EG Puma. But because of this cross map positions, I wouldn't be surprised to see him use a little bit more Banshee harassment to delay JYP from taking sort of any sort of base here, and to eke out a supply advantage for when he does attack, so that if JYP decides to do any sort of more economic build, he cannot get the advantage for when that larger push comes. We saw in the last game EG Puma was able to easily crush his opponent there. A couple of moments of insecurity at the natural of his opponent, but in the end able to push on through with those siege tanks and the Raven able to nullify most stalkers that Puma had. And we are that JYP had, and we are seeing JYP go for this natural. One comment I made in the last game, I was talking about Puma's run at NASL Season 1 where he played against MC in the finals, talking about possibly casting the games, and I realized I'd actually already done it. So go check out those games if you really like the style of EG Puma here. And actually, Puma's scouting extremely late compared to most players. Just now sending out that SCV, and he knows where his opponent's at, so not even deciding to send it up there. We could see some sort of Maka Racks go down. He does seem to have some sort of intentions with this SCV, but nothing too drastic yet. Well, I'll put the production tab back up, and we are seeing that 1-1-1 opening, the barracks creating that tech lab, and then once the starport opens, it'll be able to immediately land there and start producing out of it. So we probably will be seeing cloaked Banshees out of there. Possibly could just be a regular Banshee here, but I'll be a little bit surprised to see if he goes for the Raven first. But we saw that in the last game he was getting the Raven first, mainly to deny any sort of scouting with that Observer. We aren't seeing anything produced quite yet, just not having the enough gas here, but we are seeing that first Banshee come out, so he will get a Banshee out very quickly with a cloak and be able to put on that harassment. JYP seems to like putting down that proxy pile in exceptionally fast here, around the 6 minute mark here, so able to apply some sort of pressure here, but with the bunker here placed at the ramp here of EG Puma, not gonna be able to do too much damage. Obviously SCVs can repair the bunkers here, and actually throwing down a second one, scouting that pylon, worried about the imminent attack here, so wanting to make sure that he's gonna have enough to defend. Just Marines being produced out of here, not having the gas to spare on Tech Labs, pulling some SCVs here to repair that bunker. Very, very worried about this. But force fields will actually pull the SCVs off of this bunker, so not allowing them to repair. If this bunker does go down, though, more Marines will be able to evacuate to there. And we're seeing, yep, JYP is going to have to immediately back out, not having the firepower to take that down. Going to need something more heavier like Immortals, and we are seeing that Robo Bay going down, or Robotics Facility go down. We'll probably get the Observer out first to check his opponent. And wow, actually, we're seeing EG Puma go for the expansion here. So, shaking things up a little bit, not going to be going for the all, and just going to be applying some light Banshee harass here. We are going to be seeing that first Cloak Banshee going in, Stalker already firing away. Going to be able to cloak it up, but nothing there yet to defend, and this Robotic Facility is actually not even up yet, so this is going to be very interesting. He's going to be able to get enough kills here to warrant this Banshee's creation, so, I mean, at this point, this Banshee is going to be paying for itself in no time. We're seeing 7 kills already, and yeah, the number is just getting higher, and we're seeing that the Cloak is still going, moving out just before the Observer gets out. Definitely wants to make sure to not lose that Banshee. Any losses early in the game are obviously quite hard to surmount, and probe losses like that JYP just took are going to be very hard to make up. But because he did take that really fast expansion, we're seeing, Puma's ahead in the Harvester Cal, so very, very interesting. He was expecting the all-in, but after having done a little bit more scouting, knows that, and getting a second Observer out, so going to be scouting the main of his opponent and have the detection needed to defend here. And actually, second Banshee was making its way to the Naturals. Take a quick look at the workers killed. We're seeing, wow, 15 workers killed by Banshees, so quite a large amount here killed by Puma, and we're seeing his Harvester Cows rising quite high. JYP is going to need to Chrono Boost these out in order to catch up with JYP, or to patch up with Puma, and Mules are going to be able to spread, or to spring EG Puma quite a bit further ahead, and we're actually seeing him gear up to take even his third. So, wow, EG Puma is just powering hard. Expecting his opponent to think he's just on one base is going to be actually quite the advantage here. Has no idea of that third base up there, or technically second base at this point, and looks like he went to scout at one point. Might have been when he was scouting to see the spawning position here of his opponent. Yeah, only having scouted his opponent's front here, never being able to get the Observer in, and now that this Raven's out, if an Observer does get in, it's not gonna be able to do too much. A couple Zealots here at the Watchtower maintaining their post, one Immortal kind of out in the stray. If a Banshee were to come by, it could possibly pick this off. We're seeing Stalkers keenly positioned here, and JYP actually getting supply blocked. Now, at a crucial point in the game when he needs to be catching up, this is not the way to be doing it. We're seeing that is going to be he already needs to play quite flawlessly in order to catch up to Puma, and Puma is not going to be laying down his guard at all. And getting supply blocked like that is not the way to do it. And I just realized I haven't been set to busy, so let me go ahead and do that. But yeah, getting supply locked at crucial moments like this is not helping him. We are seeing the Robotics Bay coming down here, so Colossi will begin production here once that finishes. But yeah, Puma already on his third base. Really, there's no worry of being attacked at this point, because JYP is under the impression that he expanded before his opponent. He believes that he's going to be able to have some sort of Colossi timing push, and that's what he's counting on. But the fact is, EG Puma ended up taking that second expansion, and with taking this third, it's actually going to even him out, and as we're seeing with the Banshee kills, it's thrown him ahead into this game. So EG Puma is just outplaying JYP at this moment, showing how good of a player he is. Going to be getting a forge here, going to be used for cannons probably to defend his mineral lines here, and also allow him to get the upgrades that he so heavily is going to need. Now, like I said, I'm really worried here for JYP, not going to be having the knowledge of that third. Let's take a quick look at his vision. Still doesn't know. One key feature to even being in the Masters League at this point is to know where expansions are, and yes, sneaking expansions like that is obviously still very, very dangerous at high levels, but you need to be able to judge your opponent's army count. If we just look at the scouting that JYP has been doing, it's been very minimal because of these bunkers. That Zealot getting taken out here by that Banshee. Oddly enough, he took it out while cloaked, so using up a lot of that energy, but still, the Banshee will be useful. We're seeing 4 kills on that Banshee alone, and 15 on this one. She is a captain, so very cool. EG Puma making the best of his units, not letting a single man behind, or leaving a single man behind, and we're seeing that first Colossi already out. The second one's going to be Corona Boost out here. couple stalkers left to defend. And he's counting on this timing here to really do some damage. But with this number of bunkers and with this, I mean, this three base economy now has actually started to kick in quite handily. Let's take a look at the income tab. And actually, JYP catching up a little bit there, but not having the three base economy that his opponent does. And actually taking out these rocks. Is he aware of the fact of that base now? No, he's not aware. Interesting. Oh, going to be taking this expansion, actually. So, quite cool play, actually. You don't see players go for these expansions. You normally see them either go for this one instead of taking the time to take out that rock. Actually, a Colossi being loaded up into the Warp Prism. So, better. Hope there's no Vikings out in the field to deal with that. Take a quick look at the production tab. Once again, we are seeing three Vikings be produced right now. So, none currently poised in the main here, but Ghost Supply Depot's going down. I thought those might have been missile turrets. If he can land this Colossi, I mean, he needs to create a diversion for that Colossi to kill these SUVs, and that's exactly what he's trying to do here. Gonna attack the front here, causing EG Puma to probably divert most of his forces here to his front, and waiting for the right time to put down this Colossi. But he might be jumping the gun here a little bit. We're seeing that Vikings are still in equal distance here to defend. Actually warping in Zealots, not going to be able to defend this Colossi, getting that Warp Prism to go, and going to get intercepted very easily. Surviving a few more volleys, and it normally would have been actually, oh no, turning that Warp Prism around, mismanaging his army there. Oh, it's so painful to watch, and still completely oblivious to the fact of that third. Zealots actually still in the main here, though, doing able to do a good amount of damage. Take quickly the Worker's Kill. We're seeing now 11 for JYP, going up to 12 there for a moment. If we look at the unit's loss tab, it's actually still favoring the Terran, plus the Terran does have a better economy. So things are starting to look grim, but actually, oddly enough, Protoss has been keeping up with his worker supply. EG Puma has been foregoing his workers, probably going for some sort of three base timing. A little bit curious as to why he's doing that, but now that he does have these workers back onto this mineral field, the mineral fields in the main, you're going to start seeing his numbers actually be higher, even though having less amount of workers due to the fact that they are more evenly distributed over these three bases. Take open up that production tab. Once again, we're going to be seeing SUVs produce for EG Puma. A little surprising to see him stay at such low numbers after having snuck the base like that. You would think you'd want to get it saturated, but I guess deciding to go for this nice middle ground push here, having quite the large armor size. We're seeing him ahead by supply by 40. Ahead in supply by 40 is what I meant to say. So many Vikings going to be able to just snipe one. No Colossi yet. Colossi haven't done anything, and two of them are in the red. And now all of them are just getting taken out. This is really bad circumstance here. Wanting to wait for that charge we're seeing and that plus one attack. But some E-Han timing here by EG Puma. Going to be rolling over JYP. I mean, this is no contest. JYP GG's out. So well played there by Puma. Oh my gosh. I mean, he was looking almost unstoppable there with that really early Banshee harassment. I mean, really threw him in the lead, and then sneaking that expansion. JYP was expecting the all-in, but EG Puma instead saying, well, you're expecting that, so obviously I'm not gonna do that. So very, very cool. We're seeing actually ahead in upgrades as well with the plus one armor and attack. So EG Puma just playing so well practiced there. And I mean, gosh, JYP is going to have to shape up and really show what he's made of in the next three games. I mean, he has to do the reverse alt kill, but JYP is such a good player too. You have to remember that he's a Korean star here. So we'll go on to game number three. I mean, I really want to see JYP and EG Puma really duke it out here. JYP not playing, I don't think, to his best abilities. EG Puma playing so well, though. So I'm going to go on to game number three, guys. SC Mothership checking out.